Hey, Trace, what's
up? Hey, what's
up?
Yeah?
Yeah, there we go. Hey guys, Tara and Trace here for DNews, and you remember a while back when Obama got lambasted by conservative news outlets for fist bumping his wife during a televised campaign speech?
Ah, yes, the old terrorist fist jab.
Right, well it turns out that wasn't a political statement, it was just good hygiene. And a new study published this week in the American Journal of Infection Control shows that fist bumping is probably something we should all be doing more of.
So the goal of this study was to see how different forms of greetings transmit bacteria, from handshakes to high fives to fist bumps. So researchers took a glove, they dipped it in a container loaded with E. coli, and then let it dry, which sounds really gross. Then they shook, fist bumped, or high-fived another person who was wearing a clean glove, and afterwards they tested the clean glove for bacteria.
Turns out a handshake is just about the grossest G-rated thing you can do with another person. They transmit almost 10 times more bacteria than a fist bump and about 2 times more bacteria than a high five. And people like me, who happen to enjoy a good firm handshake, are probably the worst offenders.
Why is this though? Well, to figure it out, they repeated the experiment, but this time they dipped the gloves in paint instead of bacteria so they could see what was going on. And they found that it all comes down to surface area. When you shake someone's hand, more of your skin comes in contact with the other person's skin. So even if I were to fist bump you for 20 seconds, which would be extremely awkward.
Oh, I can't take it anymore, stop.
Yeah, it still wouldn't be as dirty as a handshake.
Well, it's not a fist bump if it doesn't last 20 seconds, said no one ever. But keep in mind this can't perfectly mimic real life because no one goes around dipping their hands into giant vats of bacteria. Trace.
Sometimes.
But the idea behind it makes sense. In business transactions, sure, shake someone's hand, but when I'm at the doctor's office or a hospital, do I really need to shake my doctor's hand?
You probably shouldn't do that. And in fact, there's an entire group of people in the medical community who are actively trying to ban hand-to-hand greetings altogether, as well as long sleeves and long coats and anything that moves bacteria through our halls of healing. Personally, I say we could take a cue from Japan and greet each other with a, you know, small bow.
Oh, yeah, that's
maybe
nice.
Like a... Maybe bring back the curtsy.
Oh, I like that. Yeah, very prim and proper.
Is that?
Just like me.
Right.
Okay. Well, I don't know. What do you guys think? The handshake is so ingrained in our culture, I'm not sure we'll ever totally get rid of it. But can you think of any alternatives that are maybe a little less gross? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, thank you guys for watching.
And if you're interested in one of these sweet shirts that I got on my body right here, then you can go over to DNews/ScienceBro.
That's from our video.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did that thing together.
You want a high five over it?
I'm good.
Fist bump?
Oh.